Hello and welcome to lecture 10. This time around, we're talking about working with different kinds of shapes and different ways to interact with them and defining basically what is a shape to begin with. So a shape is composed of points and paths. We'll discuss that on the next slide. We'll go over some different ways to work with shapes and some strategies for understanding the most efficient way to do so. So a shape is basically a combination of anchor points and lines. So those anchor points are connected with the line, and that's what we get, that's what we call a path. So as you can read that on the slide there, I don't need to read it for you, but that's the idea. So you take two anchor points, the line that connects those two is called a path. This goes back to good old-fashioned geometry that I'm sure you've all taken in high school or even junior high. You have two points. Those are not a thing, not any mass, not any scale or width or anything to that point. It is just a location. It's coordinates. It's indicated with a dot, but there's no dimensions there. It's just a location on your artboard. So that's what a point is. A line is the path that connects two or more points. So it's a vector. That's the actual mathematical term, is the vector between those two points. Describes the relationship between those two points, the angle, the distance, all those things. It also does not have any mass or width, but it does have length. So that length is determined by the distance between points, obviously. So this is purely mathematical description of what a path is, really. You start to define shapes when you add strokes to the path, for example. So the path is nothing but a description of the trajectory between two points. The stroke is what makes it visible. So that's where you add color to your line. If you add width to your line, you can add dashes and dots and all kinds of other things to your line. Fill is the thing that goes inside, the color, pattern, image, or whatever goes inside of a shape. So you can have closed shapes or open shapes. Those are going to have different behaviors and properties. But regardless, you can apply a fill to an object. And if there's some degree of shape there other than just a straight line, you're going to see some kind of filling in that area. So that's where you start to get objects that are visible and functional and usable in the design. The Bézier curve is a mathematical function that defines the curvature of a line. So by moving around the anchor points and the Bézier handles, as you can see in this little animation there on the left, you can define the exact curvature of that line, and you can create all kinds of different shapes, really infinitely variable shapes that you can create with angles and different things. So by manipulating those handles, the distance of those handles, you're going to increase or decrease the sharpness of the angle or the direction of the curve and so on and so forth. This is really, I think, very beneficial to discuss academically in these terms. You need to just open up Illustrator, get the pen tool out and start trying it out. There are some exercises that you can go through that will make a lot more sense, and we'll try and get some links posted for you to do so. So objects, now we're going to talk about objects or shapes. I mentioned before open shapes and closed shapes. Here's a literally simple illustration, closed circle, open circle, or a C or whatever you want to call that, but it's an open shape. Your fill is going to fill completely inside of closed shape, whereas an open shape, it's only going to fill to whatever extremities of that line there are. So you would have that circle filled, that partial circle filled, and then you have a straight line connecting those two endpoints where that's where your fill would end. Another type of open shape is just a swirl or a spiral or a curve like you see on the right-hand top side of that diagram. You have a beginning point and an end point, some Bézier handles, but your fill is going to be kind of funky on that sort of an object. Bottom left, looking at that square, just some descriptions of different types of points. You have corner anchor points and straight path segments. On the circle on the right, you have smooth anchor points, still anchor points, just the behavior of the line as it passes through those points is different. It's going to curve based on directions of handles and direction lines. And the line, of course, that goes between smooth anchor points becomes a curved path segment. So just the anatomy of terminology associated with those geometric shapes. There are some simple shape tools in Illustrator, the rectangle, rounded rectangle, ellipse, polygon, more complex, you get into the star tool and even more so the flare tool. But still, these are fairly simple geometric shapes that you can use. Circles and squares and lines, that's kind of what it all comes down to in Illustrator. The important thing to remember is that complex, high quality, high resolution illustrations can be made just like the concept of a photograph made up of a bunch of little pixels. Pixels is when you zoom in far enough or just little dots of color. Illustrator objects with complexity are just the same. If you remember back to when I showed you those really complex photorealistic illustrations, look at the vectors of that, or the wireframes, I should say. It's really a whole bunch of just simple shapes stacked up together cleverly to form complex patterns, images, graphics, elements that combine into something usable. So again, making a square is kind of rudimentary in Illustrator. Modifying that square into more complex shapes and combining it with other objects forms something meaningful and usable.